Hello there, and here we have a new video game that's coming out. What do you think, Lewis? Do you think this looks nice?
Oh, it's lovely.
There's a little fella there. But what's this in the sky? Oh dear! Oh dear! It's... Oh, what's he doing to the puppets?
Oh my god.
What do you think's gonna happen? What do you think's gonna happen to the puppets?
Are they all now vampires? Because they've all got teeth like a vampire.
No, Lewitt, the puppets are alive! Brilliant. Wow. So there you go.
Wow.
Monster of
Available
puppets.
Some point. Wow.
Coming in your eye.
So we don't know whether what any to do gameplay of that at all is, but apparently it's out this quarter.
Who cares? It's a cool trailer. It's gonna go viral, mate. We're gonna get a million views on this video. We're gonna be rich.
Let's do it. Goodbye.
Because on YouTube, for every view, you get £10. So with a million views,
yep,
we're gonna get £10 million.
Wow.
And I'm gonna spend it on
puppets,
Jaffa cakes, and Brian Blessed's.
You're just gonna hire him.
I'm gonna hire him. You know how you can like hire a clown for a children's party? I'm gonna hire Brian Blessed, and I'm gonna say it's like my son's birthday party, and he'll turn up, and I'll say, "Oh, it's the wrong day," but can you know stick around for a bit? You know, I'll put the kettle on. I'll pay you for it. It's fine, and I'll just do that every day.
Okay.
But it can't always be in the same house, so I'm going to have to like rent several properties. And so on Monday I'll be in the same house, and on, you know, say Fridays I'll be in a different house, and Brian will come, and I'll also have to like wear a disguise so he doesn't realize that it's always the same person hiring him to turn up.
Yeah,
to these non-existent children parties.
Okay,
I have to hire some child actors or dwarves to pose as children,
right,
for the pretend party.
Okay.
As well,
I mean, what if other people wanted to hire the Brian Blessed's party services? I mean, how would you ensure that he was always, you know, booked up to go?
I would book in advance.
Okay.
I would book 10 years in advance.
Okay. Oh God. Okay.
Luckily, I started booking him for these events 9 years, 10 months ago. So I'm right on schedule.
Right.
Poor Brian Blessed's agent is, I'm afraid there's no new roles for you in any theatre productions or any films or TV series at the moment, Brian. But it's okay, because in a couple of months, you're fully booked. Your schedule is totally packed, Brian. It's amazing. And Brian's like, I can't wait! Oh, I'm looking forward to these children's parties!
What do you do with Brian all day when he's around? Right?
I just sort of sit around. We have a cup of tea and we talk about things.
Every day?
You know, he talks about being a mountaineer and, you know, being goosed by Sir John Gielgud.
But, I mean, what about doing all the, you know, stuff that you have to do, like going to the shops and sweeping the porch?
I take him with me.
Doing the washing up.
I take him with me.
And getting some stuff out of the
we
loft.
We do that together. I wash, he dries.
Right. It gets things done twice as fast.
And sometimes when I'm like, I've finished washing a plate and I like hand it over to him and he takes it, sometimes our hands touch briefly.
Oh.
And we sort of look up into each other's eyes.
But you look different every time.
There's just a moment that we share.
Because the
disguises.
Yeah.
I have to wear different contact lenses as well so he doesn't recognise the eyes.
Oh my goodness. And how do you disguise the voice as well?
I can do literally a million different voices, Lewis. It's not a problem.
Okay.
So he'd never recognize
me. Twig.
I just blend in.
Do you have to sort of wear for like fat suits and thin suits and things like this to make your body type like different, like taller, just to wear like stilts.
Now, I know what a fat suit is, right? It makes you look a bit like a sumo wrestler, you know, it's like a sumo thing that they do, you know, like a giant inflatable sort of suit. But what is a thin suit?
Right. Well, it only works on very fat people, and what it does, it squeezes all the fat into like a certain place. So, for example, what you do is you like,
Like their
well,
ankles.
yeah, like you squeeze down, like from the knee, like
It's
almost
like
like
a
you're
body
putting, yeah,
corset.
and you push all the fat down into the ankles, and then what you do is you wear very, very big shoes or flared trousers, and then it's hidden, or
Wow.
Wellington boots.
That's brilliant.
Yeah. And obviously,
Flared
the same thing,
trousers.
you have to sort of do the same thing with your the fat on the rest of your body as well. So you've got very big wrists and also a very big neck.
Oh my
Have to wear a
God.
scarf.
You'd look really weird. Just really thin, but you just have like these weird bulging wrists, ankles, and your neck. It would look like you're wearing like a ruff.
That's right.
You know, like an Elizabethan gent.
Yeah. God, when are they going to get back in fashion? Ruffs.
I don't know, but I can't wait. They're amazing ruffs.
I can't wait.
I like a nice bit of ruff. Wow. So there we go.
Okay.
Monster of Puppets is out. It's out soon.